and Dr. Meera K from Ramaya Medical College. I'm going to present the case of Mrs. Rana Bala Chakrabarty, age 63-year-old female, hailing from West Bengal, housewife, belonging to low socioeconomic status, came with the chief complaints of yellowish discoloration of urine and eyes since 2 months, complaints of pain abdomen since 1.5 months, and nausea and vomiting since 1.5 months. History of presenting NS. The patient was apparently all right 2 months back when she noticed yellowish discoloration of urine and eyes, which was insidious in onset, gradually progressive, not associated with veining and waxing of jaundice. It was associated with pain abdomen, clay-colored stool, and generalized itching. Patient also gives history of pain in the right upper quadrant of abdomen since 1.5 months, insidious in onset, dull aching type, continuous, mild to moderate in intensity, non-radiating, not referred, no aggravating factors, and relieved on taking oral analgesics. Patient also gives history of nausea and vomiting since 1.5 months. Vomiting is on and off episodes, non-projectile, small quantity, watery, gastric content, not blood or bile stain, non-foul smelling, not associated with food intake. However, the nausea is aggravates after taking food. Patient also gives history of dyspepsia since 1 month, loss of appetite, and loss of weight, which she couldn't quantify. However, she says she had significant loosening of clothes. Negative history, no history of hematemesis or melena, no history of fever, no history of previous blood transfusions, no history of drug intake or mass abdomen, no history of altered bowel habits. For the above complaint, she had shown to a local hospital in her village and she was treated with oral medication. However, the symptoms didn't subside and she was referred here for further management. Past history, the patient was diagnosed to have diabetes mellitus 2 months back and is on oral hypoglycemic agent for the same. There is no history of any other medical comorbidities, no history of jaundice or biliary colic in the past. Family history, there is no history of history suggestive of any malignancies in the family. Personal history, she has mixed diet, reduced appetite, regular bowel habits, undisturbed sleep, no history of substance abuse, and she attained menopause 15 years back. Coming to examination, she's an elderly female, moderately built, poorly nourished, with BMI of 19.1.
Not audible. I think PPT is not visible on screen. The older PPT is still available, if someone can rectify.
Sir, is it seen now, sir?
Stop sharing and reshare the PowerPoint.
Okay, sir.
Veer, please unshare your PPT.
Is it seen, sir?
Yeah,
it's okay.
Sorry, sir.
You are doing well, doctor. You please proceed with the presentation.
Okay. General physical examination. As an elderly female, moderately built, poorly nourished, with a BMI of 19.1 kg per meter square, with ECOG score of 1. She has ictus, deep yellow green, noted in the sclera, floor of the mouth and abdominal wall.
I think PPT is not visible.
Sir, the PPT is visible to us.
Yeah, it is visible to us.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll try. Is it
fine, sir? Yeah, now it's visible.
No signs of dehydration. Scratch marks were noted over legs and forearms. No signs of liver cell failure. Pulse rate of 72 beats per minute, noted in right radial artery. BP of 118 to 78 mmHg in right brachial artery. Patient was afebrile at the time of examination. Coming to per abdominal examination. After taking informed consent, patient was exposed from nipple to mid thigh. Inspection, abdomen is flat, pelvis is normal in shape and position, all corresponding quadrants move equally with respiration, there is yellowish discoloration noted over the anterior abdominal wall, there is no scars, visible veins or visible gastric peristalsis, no pulsations, flanks are not full, renal angles are normal, No, all hernial orifices are normal, and left supraclavicular fossa is normal. Patient, there is tenderness noted in the right hypochondriac region and epigastrium on deep palpation. A 3 into 3 centimeter globular mass is noted in the right hypochondrium. All borders are well made up except the superior border, wherein the fingers cannot be insinuated below the costal margin. The surface is smooth, consistency is firm. The swelling moves with respiration, and there is side-to-side mobility. The plane of the swelling is intra-abdominal, intra-peritoneal, likely gallbladder. Lower border of liver is palpable 1 centimeter below the costal margin on deep inspiration. There is no splenomegaly, no other mass palpable. Bilateral renal angle, no mass palpable, no tenderness. Supraclavicular fossa, no swelling is known. Question: liver span is 15 centimeter from the fifth intercostal space in mid-clavicular line. Gallbladder note is different from that of the liver note. No free fluid noted. Auscultation, normal bowel sounds heard and no buoys were noted. Per vaginal examination was normal. Per rectal examination, normal. No bogginess felt, no lumbar shell felt. Respiratory system, bilateral normal vesicular breath sounds heard. No evidence of pleural effusion. So, cardiovascular system, S1 and S2 heart, and CNS, normal higher mental function. Coming to differential diagnosis, obstructive jaundice, probably secondary to the carcinoma head of pancreas, cholangiocarcinoma.
Please proceed, doctor.
Okay, we will discuss with the history first.
Yes.
You said the patient had a weight loss. What do you mean by a significant weight loss?
10% weight reduction in the weight in 6 months.
Anything more to be added to this? It's not only 10% of the weight loss in the preceding 6 months. It is can. And it should be an unintentional weight loss.
Yes.
Okay. Yes. So that is the important thing. The person is going to be doing having a weight loss because of an intentional one, then it doesn't come under a significant weight loss. Okay. And you said the patient had a sleep pattern. What was the sleep pattern you expected in this patient?
If the patient had severe pain, the sleep would have been disturbed, but she has mild pain which subsides on taking oral analgesics. So the pain is not that severe in this case.
Okay. So the sleep pattern, it may not be altered only because of the pain. Okay. The sleep pattern can get reversed. Patient can have a daytime sleepiness whenever there's going to be a liver cell failure.
Yes.
Right. And what was the pulse rate in this patient?
And pulse rate was 78 beats per minute.
Okay. So what change do you expect in a person with a jaundice in the pulse rate?
Patient might have tachycardia.
Tachycardia. Why?
If the patient had associated fever with it, we can suspect of cholangitis.
Only talking
and then
about liver cell failure when the liver is impaired. It will be bradycardia.
So there will be relative bradycardia. Okay, this relative bradycardia. Why do you have this? It is because of the bile salts which are going to be deposited over the sinoatrial node. You tend to have a relative bradycardia. Okay.
You said there is an itching in the legs and the forearm.
Yes.
It's a significant. It's a diabetic fellow, the old man, diabetic. When there is an itching in the periphery, is it significant of an obstructive jaundice, or why do you get a jaundice? Itching you are expecting.
So mainly, she had itching in the periphery, sir.
Periphery. Centripetal or centrifugal?
In the arms and limbs, both the limbs she had, sir.
An old man with a diabetic with the thing in the arms, we will not consider as an obstructive jointitis as a first cause. There are too many other skin diseases. It is now only it is centripetal and it should be in the abdomen or if you that is possible. Why do you get itching? Why do you get itching?
Due to deposition of bile salts in the dermal, subdermal dermis and activation of the mast cell to release histamine.
The color of the stool is clay. What is the color? Clay color in your area? What is the color of the clay in your area?
It's pale colored. Pale stool, sir.
You must, when you are using the word clay and you must be very careful because the clay is not pale in color. So it must be, the history must be the change in color or if there is a change in the alteration, the color is becoming a pale and that is more significant on that. You said both jaundice and ulceration of the urine was noted 1.5 months back. Both occur simultaneously.
Sorry, sir.
In the symptoms, which will occur first in the case of obstructive jaundice? Is that a jaundice first or you get an.
The first jaundice
will happen. Discoloration of the urine.
Sorry, sir. It's not clear, sir.
Okay. What is the difference between hyperbilirubinemia and jaundice? Hyperbilirubinemia and jaundice both are same or different?
Hyperbilirubinemia is more than 1.2 mg per deciliter. If the serum albumin bilirubin level is more, then it is hyperbilirubinemia. Whereas for jaundice to occur, the bilirubin level should be more than 2 to 2.5 mg per deciliter.
Now you lost the history of waxing and baney, but your total history duration of the history is only 1.5 months. What is the normal duration you expect for the waxing and baney to take place? Suppose there's the history only 2 weeks, one month. Do you expect there is a waxing and baney?
The tumor should grow to a sufficient.
Waxing and baney. Waxing and baney.
You are talking, bro.
So actually, you are able to.
Hello.
Other reasons where you get a waxing and waning.
Sir, we will get waxing and waning even in CBD stones, sir.
What type of CBD stone? What type of CBD stones? All CBD stones?
Yes, sir. Once the stone passes down, the
slipping stone.
Yes.
Slip rock stone. What are the condition? What else?
A periampullary carcinoma.
Why in periampullary carcinoma?
There is necrosis. When the tumor grows in size, there is central necrosis and sloughing will happen.
Why is central necrosis?
Because the blood supply is not, the central area will not get sufficient blood supply, so there will be
what is the size of the periapical carcinoma when it starts necrosing? What is the probable size of the malignancy?
Slipping stone.
So it is about 2.5 centimeter. So up to 2 centimeter, the blood supply does occur. When it goes beyond 2.5 centimeter, the blood supply will be decreased. Then start necrosing and sloughing off. What is the third condition where you get the vaccine banning jaundice? One is it periampullary, second is slip rock stone, slip rock CBD stone.
Primary sclerosing cholangitis we can get for intermittent jaundice.
No. Primary sclerosis is a continuous progressive disease. What is other? Some worms can have a positive worms can also can once it passes off, they can have vaccine banning jaundice.
Yes,
okay, continue.
I'll go to the management.
Okay. I mean the examination.
Examination.
You said and palpation. Gallbladder is palpable on deep palpation.
Expect
the gallbladder to palpable on a deep palpation.
Sir, liver is palpable on deep palpation. Gallbladder is palpable, sir.
when you were presenting, you said on deep palpation, there is a 3 into 3 centimeter mass is palpable. Plus 20 second, and when you are doing a percussion also, you said on the gallbladder, it was a superficial, I mean, it is an impaired. And so now you are able to differentiate between a gallbladder and a mass. Is it a gallbladder mass?
Sir, what I felt was the note of the hepatomegaly is different from that of the gallbladder that I felt.
The note?
The percussion note was different.
That is true, but you said it is over the gallbladder. Initially, you said it is a mass.
Sir?
The mass or a gallbladder?
It is a gallbladder mass, so likely gallbladder, because it is in the right hypochondrium, all the borders are made out, superior border is not made out, and moves with respiration. Consistency, it's firm, and side-to-side mobility is also there.
Oh, Meera, you are not able to understand what sir is asking. Sir is asking that is distended gallbladder which you are palpating or a mass?
Distended gallbladder, sir.
Okay. Meera, what else can be mistaken like for distended gallbladder, apart from gallbladder? Similar findings, what are the other conditions where you can get exactly like similar condition like gallbladder? Any idea?
Riddles.
Yeah, fantastic. Riddle slope. All good riddle slope mimics like gallbladder.
Yes.
Yeah, good. And you said there's no splenomegaly. I strongly object for it because you can't say there's no splenomegaly in clinical examination. You can only say there's no spleen is not clinically palpable. But it needs four times for the normal size of the spleen to get clinically palpable. So your word is no splenomegaly is not acceptable.
Okay.
Yeah, please continue.
Meera, I have got a very simple question for you.
Yes, sir.
When you say waxing and waning, what are the questions that you ask the patient?
Whether the jaundice patient initially had jaundice and then it reduced and then again...
How does the patient know that the jaundice is reduced?
The intensity of the yellow discoloration reduces, sir.
No. That's not right. You have to answer the question. Dr. Abhay Dalvi is very clear in asking what history you take from the patient. The patient doesn't know jaundice come down or not. But the sense of well-being is present in patient's history. That you should try to elicit. That is more important.
Maybe itching and what will come down.
Yeah, sense of well-being rather. Sense of well-being. Patient feels comfortable. Patient suffering. Suffering has come down. Pain has come down. It feels increase, uptake is increased. That's what is main important point. Exactly. Am I correct, Dr. Abhay sir?
Yes, absolutely. See, when the jaundice decreases, the patient starts feeling better. It is not necessary that the patient visibly sees decrease in jaundice. Yes,
and one more thing, when there is going to be a waxing and waning of a jaundice, what is the other history you are supposed to elicit along with this?
Any history of biliary colic in the past?
It is a melina what you're supposed to ask.
What is the difference between colicky pain and throbbing pain?
Colicky pain is intermittent pain. It is due to the tubular structures, sir. And throbbing pain is more because of vascular inflammation. In that situation, you get throbbing kind of
pain. No. Come again. What is throbbing?
Throbbing is because of inflammation, abscess, because of vascular.
Vascular?
Because of inflammation, sir.
inflammation.
Abscess.
Throbbing, you get throbbing pain in an abscess.
Abscess, yes.
Why?
How do you get that?
Why?
Something
stretches there.
Correct.
Something stretches.
It's not inflammation. It is an expansion.
Expansion. Stretching. I give the clue to you.
Define an abscess.
Got the basics. Yes.
Abscess is
yes.
Kind of dead necrotic tissue with neutrophils.
Collection of pus in an enclosed.
Enclosed
space.
There is a capsule. Now, if it stretches, you start getting throbbing pain. Just to deviate, I know you must have read a lot of obstructive jaundice, but you must have even basically drained more abscesses. Yes. So I want to know
whether you abscess has only dead tissues.
Sorry, sir.
You said abscess has a dead tissues. Is it only abscess will have a dead tissue? Is there, no, sir, there be any living tissues?
Neutrophils will be there, sir, and microorganisms.
Microorganisms will be there.
Does not matter, Meera. Let's come to your diagnosis of obstructive jaundice. How will you go about investigating?
Sir, first to confirm obstructive jaundice, we'll get liver function test and test done.
When you ask for liver function test and when the report comes in your hand,
yes, sir.
Tell me what are the things that are there in the report that you would like to tell me.
So first I would like to see the total bilirubin and the direct bilirubin.
Okay.
If the direct bilirubin value is...
Wait. What is my question? What are the things
What all will you see?
Now, if you are going to start telling me if direct is more, etc., etc., you are inviting me.
Yes.
Don't invite me. You tell what I have asked.
Total bilirubin, direct bilirubin. Then I'll be looking at the alkaline phosphatase level and protein for the nourishment of the patient, sir. Protein and albumin level for the nourishment of the patient. Transaminases will be completely elevated.
Albumin level for the nourishment of the patient or anything else?
And the liver function, sir. Liver secretory function.
Okay,
if your enzymes and the are in thousands,
yes,
are you
sir.
Concerned with this or you are okay with this?
AC, ALT are in thousands, sir.
Yes.
Some liver pathology, underlying liver pathology will be there if they are elevated.
Anything like cholangitis or dealing with a separate system, infection of the biliary tree, what will be the manifestation of that in the liver function test?
If there is obstruction, ALP will be increased, sir. And AST, ALT will be increased if there is any hepatitis. It shows.
Please move ahead.
You are on the right track. Destruction of hepatocytes equal to enzyme rise. That is what you should answer.
Yes.
Okay. So let's say bilirubin is 10, direct is 10.5.
Yes, sir.
HGPT is little bit raised. PTINR is normal. Prothrombin
yes,
are normal.
Yes,
now,
sir.
What is the next thing that you would like?
Next, I would like to investigate the mass that is there.
So go ahead, investigate.
I will get like to get the ultrasound abdomen done, sir.
So tell me what is the question which I had asked the previous candidate, I am asking you. When you are asked this question,
yes, sir.
When you are going to answer ultrasound, tell me what information ultrasound is likely to give you vis-a-vis the examination findings.
Ultrasound will tell us if the mass that is first, it will tell us about the mass, whether the mass is gallbladder or not. And it will tell us about the extrahepatic biliary radical dilatation and intrahepatic biliary radical dilatation. And it can also assess pancreas at the same time.
Very nice. Anything else that you are going to ask the sonologist to tell to look for? Diagnosis is lower end malignancy.
Yes, sir.
Around the amplitude of Vater.
Yes, sir.
So, you know that you are dealing with malignancy. You have asked for sonography.
Yes, sir.
But you may not be able to see the tumor. Fine. You have answered properly extrahepatic, intrahepatic, biliary radical dilatation. You have said distension of the gallbladder. Anything else you want to know?
Yes, sir. hepatomegaly if it is there.
Very good.
Then ascites, if ascites is present or not, free fluid.
Nice. Mira, you have to be very clear in your mind.
Stones in the cigarette.
Indirectly, what I'm trying to ask you is whether there is spread of disease, which can be made out on ultrasound. So local pathology, then effect of the pathology, that is dilatation of the biliary tree and of the gallbladder, and then hepatomegaly, then the spread of disease. How does malignancy spread? How does a lower end malignancy spread?
Lymph nodal metastasis, and through the submucosal plane, it will go up.
Will lymph nodes be affected?
Hello?
Which lymph node will you look for? Or tell the
sonometer. Hepatoduodenal lymph nodes are the first lymph nodes that are involved. After that, we'll have the periportal lymph nodes and the retropancreatic lymph nodes.
And also, you can make out on sonology, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, sonologist has given you report. No nodes. Dilatation of intrahepatic biliary tree is there. Extrahepatic biliary dilatation right up to the duodenum is there.
Sir, I would like to do CCT abdomen and pelvis.
Go ahead.
I would like to do CCT abdomen and pelvis. It will tell better about better information about the lymph node status, and it will also give us information about the vascular structures are involved or not, and the proper extent of the tumor will also be delineated.
Which vessels do you think are involved in the distal malignancy?
Sir, if it is superior mesenteric vein, portal vein, and gastroduodenal vein, artery can be involved.
How do you make out gastroduodenal vein on CT scan?
We can.
Then why? Again, I'm catching you. You are giving more information. Okay, than required. Yeah. Supramesenteric vein is not involved. Vein is not involved. Now what? Peoples?
No, sir.
Then?
No, it's okay.
What else? Come on.
The extent of the tumor.
Sir. You have not yet reached the diagnosis only.
And pipes.
You have not reached the diagnosis. Now, I appreciate your clinical knowledge. But then, as a patient, I'm going to ask you. मेरा इतना बड़ा ऑपरेशन करने वाले हो, यू आर ऑपरेटिंग ऑन मी सच अ बिग ऑपरेशन, वेयर इज द डायग्नोसिस?
वी कैन डू एन एमआरसीपी टू डिलिनिएट द
नहीं नहीं नहीं
दैट विल नॉट बी डायग्नोसिस.
कैन आई व्हाट इज डायग्नोसिस? हेल्प मी समबडी प्लीज हेल्प.
नो व्हाट इज बेटर डायग्नोसिस? इन्वेस्टिगेट मोर्टालिटी टू कंफर्म इट डायग्नोसिस.
ईआरसीपी एंड end. Biopsy Hello. Can be taken if it is this lower end.
Suppose it is not showing mass, still you want biopsy, what can you do?
ERCP and breast cytology.
That is inconclusive. You don't see mass on CT. You are
EUS and then we can do an FNAC from if at all we find any lesion.
Yes.
From Mira,
is any tumor markers available? Any tumor markers? Need tumor markers?
The CA-19-9 carbohydrate.
That can help you out some extent.
The CA-19-9 can be.
But it is not specific to malignancy.
It's not specific. Guides you. So in addition, helps you to guide you EUAS, then FNAC.
Yes.
Dr. Dr. Meera, the point Abhay sir wanted is the patient is going to ask you, you are planning for a 5-6 hour of operation involving multiple anastomosis, and you are telling you have chance of very high complication of after the surgery.
Yes, sir.
Do I have a confirmation of the pathology? The current guidelines are...
Another thing is, sorry for interrupting.
Yes, sir.
Is it must to have a histopathology if I'm going ahead with your probably procedure of surgery? Is it a must? What is the latest guidelines?
If it is palliative, then we need a tissue diagnosis. Otherwise, we can go ahead with the surgery. And
the point is, now the era of pancreatic surgery is heading towards neoadjuvant downstaging therapy. Number one, especially your radiology evidence is not suggesting that you may end up having an R0 resection. Or if the tumor is attempting to invade into the vascular structure, then you definitely there is a benefit of the neoadjuvant therapy. If you are planning for a neoadjuvant therapy, biopsy, either in the form of cytology, ideally differentiation status also should be known. The invasive status of the tumor are also to be known to plan for a neoadjuvant therapy.
Yes.
At this point, neoadjuvant therapy obviously means gemcitabine-based monotherapies or gemcitabine and taxane-based polytherapy. We stop there with that. We are not going to oncology part of it. Number two, if you have a 1 centimeter sized lesion, whether it can be a common bile duct, it can be an ampullary or a head tumor, less than 1 centimeter size lesion, whatever be the modality you do, may be a challenge for establishing the histology. Number three, at times, biliary tumors can present with only as a malignant stricture. You don't see a mass at all. Then you may technically not be able to establish. You may tell it is positive for malignancy or negative for malignancy, and you have a very high risk of your ERCP procedure or an endoscopic ultrasound guided procedure to become negative. All right. So the examiners want to know, are you aware of the recent advance, something called spyglass? Spyglass is the one system to ERCP. You are able to see the lumen of the bile duct where you will be able to physically take a biopsy under vision. First, when you do a EUS, it is a window image, like I would say shadow-based guided FNAC, very precise. But the most precise common bile duct tissue access is at this point of time is a spyglass-based. Okay. At this point of time, the third issue what we should be well aware is, if the tumor is primarily resectable, if you are confident that you are going to do a R0 resection, in presence of dilated biliary tree, it is worthwhile considering a Whipple's pancreatic duodenectomy, provided patient's performance status is good enough for holding such a long surgery. This is all you have to tell. You don't need a clear-cut preoperative histology for deciding this patient. All right. As you rightly said, if you're doing only a palliative procedure, the biopsy can be preoperative. See, if it is a huge mass in the head of pancreas causing duodenal obstruction, going in for a sake of diversion, you'll be able to take some amount of tissue. Sometimes you may still have challenge of taking a biopsy. Please be armed with a two-cut biopsy for taking a tissue for your confirmation. Because patient may say, you have done a bypass only for a chronic mass-forming pancreatitis. What biopsy evidence to tell? Because the oncologist will be very particular. Unless you are going to give them a tissue diagnosis of what cytology or what histology you are going to do, they will not be able to do. The perioperative biopsy is itself a short note question for you. So be prepared with that. The NCCN guidelines give very clear approach to this. All right. Now, let the faculty take over the other things, because the PG should be aware of what is happening on the biopsy per se. All right. May I request the faculty to take over, please? Okay, Samir.
Sir, Samir.
Yeah. You've been always quiet.
See, you did the endoscopy, you did the biopsy. Yes, this sir. Patient bilirubin is 10.
Yes, sir.
What to do next? Because Dr. Robert Albisar said this bilirubin is 10.
Yes, sir. We can, since bilirubin...
Yeah, yeah, continue. Continue.
Since bilirubin is 10, we can see the nutritional status of the patient and then counsel the patient for the surgery.
What about, why 10? Suppose your water body is 20. I think you should understand the question about Samir, whether the patient requires drainage, preoperative drainage or not. If what are the reasons, what are the indications, what is the limitation bilirubin levels to train or not to train? Is there any, what is the latest school of thought? That's what he wants to know.
Sir, if we do pre-op endoscope, ERCP and stenting, there are more chances of introduction of microbes and post-operative complications of infection. If the patient's nutritional status is good and the patient is not if the patient's nutritional status is good, we can, even if it is 10, we can proceed with the surgery.
We can proceed, but if it is 20?
Meera, I am asking you a simple question here. The issue is whether preoperative stenting or preoperative drainage or no. WBC count is 18,000. Now what will you do?
Drain or no drain?
We have to drain.
So not only nutritional condition, but also you want to roll out colonitis. Yes. And even if the patient is asymptomatic, you can ask whether there is an occult colonitis in this patient or no. I believe bilirubin is not a contraindication for going ahead without him.
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
Yes, sir.
What is the effect of high bilirubin when you are operating? What is the precautions you will take? Bilirubin is more than 20. What are the complications you will expect? Acute tubular necrosis of the kidney is one of the major complications with that. You must be extremely cautious on that. Suppose you do not have a ERCP, is there any other way of drainage?
Percutaneous transhepatic decompression.
Double duct sign on a CT scan?
Sir, there will be a dilatation of the pancreatic duct and the distal CBD, sir. Due to obstruction.
Now, if the CT reports to you that pancreas looks normal,
yes,
and
sir.
CT reports to you that there is evidence of chronic pancreatitis also, in presence of malignancy, the surgeon, which of the chronic pancreatitis will be happy or a normal pancreas will be happy?
Sir, chronic pancreatitis, if the patient has, there will be pancreatic insufficiency. So, once surgery is done, chances of more complications, whereas if pancreas is good, preserved.
Have you seen a pancreatic duodenectomy?
Yes, sir.
Have you seen pancreas being anastomosed to the intestine or the stomach?
Intestine, yes, sir.
You have seen, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tell me how easy it is to do the anastomosis in a normal pancreas and a firm pancreas.
So there will, if the pancreas is soft and fragile, it will be difficult.
So that's why I asked
ductimico, sir.
There is chronic pancreatitis and there is a normal pancreas. Which patient you are happier as a surgeon?
Chronic pancreatitis.
Thank you very much. My question is logical and simple.
Here, suppose you have the blood level shows the serum albumin is 2.
Yes, sir.
What do you will do?
So we have to increase the nutrition. We can. We have to feed. Give enteral feedings to the patient.
No.
How long it takes time to it is recovered?
minimum 2 weeks.
6 weeks. Is there any role of albumin which you are giving?
It will only increase the extra vascular volume. It will increase. It will only increase the protein content of the body.
No evidence to say that extra albumin which you are giving is important, and you have to only have enough time to for the liver to recover.
Okay. Yes.
Let me take you away from malignancy of the lower end of. Tell me all complications caused by gallstones.
Gallstone complication. One is acute calculus cholecystitis. Mm-hmm. Time gallbladder. Then mucosal of the gallbladder. If it is stuck at the level of the neck of the gallbladder, then it can
Empyema also it is stuck.
Yes.
At the neck.
Yes.
Which comes first, mucosal or empyema?
Mucosal. Mucosal.
Then why you told me empyema before mucosal?
Then CBD stones.
No. Very clear. Causing problems in the gallbladder, gallstones causing problems in common bile. You have not yet finished gallbladder.
The
stone remains impacted.
It can go and get impacted near the heart pouch and then compress on the CHD.
I am still talking about gallbladder. You told me mucosal.
Gangrenous gallbladder. Emphysematous gangrenous gallbladder.
What is mucosal, by the way? What is mucosal of the gallbladder?
Because of obstruction, the mucus is created will be collected and the gallbladder.
When the obstruction out of the bile enters the gallbladder.
Sorry, sir?
When it's stone obstructs out of the bile enters the gallbladder.
It is just the mucus that is there, sir. Secretions of the gallbladder itself.
Very good, very good.
So you have mucosal, then you have empyema of the gallbladder. Yes. It keeps on distending. Can give
perforation.
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 It can be localized or it can be generalized.
Tendonitis.
And if nothing of that sort happens and the patient starts becoming all right, patient develops chronic cholecystitis. And if the stone keeps on remaining there in the gallbladder, slowly goes into one of the orifices. What condition? If it goes into a hollow viscous, especially the urethra, and stone, large stone enters the intestine, what condition the patient presents with?
Paralytic gallstone ileus.
Gallstone ileus. So these are all that can last, but not the least, is malignant. And now I'm telling you, stone starts pressing on the common bile duct, is give rise to jaundice. What is that condition known as?
Mirisi syndrome.
Mirisi syndrome. I'm not going to ask you types of Mirisi because I know that you have read.
What is courvoisier's law?
In a jaundice patient, palpable gallbladder is.
Wait, Meera. Either causes jaundice or it causes small stone.
Gallbladder.
Small stone slips into the common bile duct.
It will cause colicky pain and obstructive jaundice, sir.
Biliary pancreatitis?
Biliary.
Somebody shouting. Pancreatitis.
Yes, sir.
So these are many, many symptoms and complications of gallstones.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Of gallstones?
Sorry, sir.
Type of gallstones.
Preventive gallstones, cholesterol gallstones, mixed gallstones.
Come again.
Commoner first.
Cholesterol gallstones. Pigmented and mixed.
What is characteristic of cholesterol stone? I will not say stones. I will say stone.
It will be a hexagonal shape and brownish yellow in colors.
Can you comment about the numbers and the color of the cholesterol stone?
It will be solitary and it will be proper shape will be like hexagonal or pentagonal shape.
What is a sludge? What is
sludge? It is bile.
Are the patients which are develop acute colitis are likely to go?
Sorry, sir.
Which are the patients in which can develop acute colitis that is are more prone to gangrene?
Diabetics.
Very good. Diabetic patients. Obviously, they don't have any symptoms. They may not have even pain. Why? Yes, why?
Neuropathy.
Very good. Neuropathy. You're good, huh? Really good. But you are still holding on quite well.
Yes, sir.
Let's come back to Vipul's. Now we'll go into theory.
Yes, sir.
You prefer? Suppose it's INR source 2.3.
Okay.
Yes,
how
sir.
You are going to manage? Your INR value is high.
Sir, initially we will give a vitamin K injection for 3 days, 10 mg.
Do you want to give vitamin K?
Sorry, sir.
Why do you want to give vitamin K?
Sir, in jaundice, fat-soluble vitamins are not absorbed. That is ADEK. So, and prothrombin synthesis is also reduced. So, we give vitamin K, which is required for these factors.
Vitamin K is not absorbed. Where the vitamin K is absorbed?
Sir?
Where is the vitamin K is absorbed?
Intestine
is a long area.
Ileum, sir. Huh? Ileum.
Where in the ileum, where are the... The deconjugation of the bacteria is not happening in place. So, can you give a oral vitamin K?
It won't be useful, sir, because again it requires fat for absorption.
In obstructive jaundice, vitamin K will not be absorbed because the enterohepatic circulation is not taking place adequately. No. That is why in the neonate also you give. Where there is no adequate bacteria is there, you are giving. So, at what level of INR you will start treating?
So, if it is more than 2.
More than 2. What is the normal normal values?
1 to 2. 1 less than 1 is the normal value.
Okay. Anything more than that of 30% and we need to start to. How many doses of injection?
10 mg IM OD for 3 days, sir.
What is INR? What is INR?
International normalized ratio, sir. It is.
So it's a ratio, right?
Yes, sir.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 INR. What is ratio with?
Sorry, sir.
Is it a ratio with what?
PP, sir. Control and. Patient's prothrombin time.
Correct.
Very that nice. Area. Okay. Very good.
So let's come back to Vipul's. Yes. You want to discuss Vipul's? Yes. So tell me, in some circumstances, you would prefer jejunum or stomach as the organ of anastomosis with the pancreatic duct?
Sir,
jejunum. Fair enough. It's your choice. I'm quite sure Kanak will agree with the latest literature. It depends on what comfortable you are. What did you watch when anastomosis was done?
So it is duct to mucosa anastomosis that is done.
Yes. Suture material, come back to the same questions. Suture material used.
Bicryls, sir.
Really? Not zero?
Really?
I'm not sure, sir.
Bicryl, that pancreatic juice will digest it immediately.
Yes, sir.
Better options?
TDS.
Proline.
Or?
Or proline.
Would you like to stent it?
Yes, sir. If it is less than 5 mm, we have to stent, sir.
Very good. And what zero material? You did not tell me. I'm asking you this because you said you have assisted.
Future size, yes, it is very important.
307, I'm not sure.
You are not. Okay, does not matter. Round body or cutting needle?
Round body, sir.
Round body. Everybody now knows what I'm going to ask. That's
the size of needle.
What tent will you use in case you think of tenting it?
Sir?
What tent will you use?
Or what can you use?
Plastic
sensors. What is available for you to use?
Sister, give me this.
You cannot say plastic material.
Something to do with infants.
Infant feeding tubes.
Thank you very much.
What will happen to the stent?
We have
kept the stent.
Would you like to fix it with one of the sutures or you will just...
Sorry, sir, I didn't get it, sir.
Will you like to fix it with one of the sutures or will you like to keep it as it is?
Keep it as it is, sir, we'll remove.
Then it will slip off. That is why I ask you what will happen to stent.
It comes out naturally.
Okay. Meera, you have managed these patients post Whipple's in the ward?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What specifically investigation do you do to know whether there is a pancreatic anastomotic leak?
Sir, drain fluid serum amylase we have to take and send it. And
that is not serum amylase.
Drain amylase we have to take and send it, and if it is more than 3 times the serum amylase, pancreatic leak is.
No, no. What if it is pancreatic leak? How much amount do you expect? Suppose it is 400-500 international unit. Will it be pancreatic leak?
Sir,
if it is pancreatic,
what was the question, sir?
If it is pancreatic leak, how much will be the reading of fluid amylase in thousands?
Three times the serum amylase values.
No, it is in thousands.
So classify pancreatic leak following Whipple.
And grade A, B, and C.
Go ahead. Anagwell is nodding his head, yes.
And not interrupting us.
See, when you are asked these questions, take it from me, you have already passed.
Yes,
that for sure. These sort of questions, people don't reach at all. So once you reach a level of discussion or complications of a major operation, you should be confident that you are passed. Now you have two options.
Yes, sir.
You know or you don't know. Quickly say don't know and get out. You will pass. Otherwise, if you don't, you talk.
Higher questions of kaun banega karorpati.
You have to take a decision whether to conserve this patient or not to conserve this. It's a very vital decision for the surgeon to take in a post-operative situation.
Yes, sir.
When do you think you will conserve this patient to what level? No, I have to go in. After going in, what is done, God knows.
I didn't get the question, sir.
See, whenever there is a pancreatic leak, pancreatic or duodenostomy leak following a Whipple's operation,
yes, sir,
the surgeon has to take a decision whether a conservative modality of treatment is to be taken or operative modality. So,
yes, sir,
determines you to decide, I should operate on this patient or I should conserve this patient.
If the output is persistently high and if the patient requires readmission and for
inpatient only.
We have never discharged the patient.
Okay. If the leak is persistent for more than 3 weeks, if it is persistent and the quantity is high and it's affecting the nourishment of the patient, we have to intervene.
What medicines or drugs may help in reducing the incidence or contain the leak?
Octreotide can help, sir. Somatostatin.
Those.
50 to 200 micrograms subcutaneous. We have to give 8 hourly.
Perfect. Sorry to disturb you, sir. Dr. Meera, yes, please, in consideration with the question Professor Dalvi asked, what are the indication for reoperation following a high drain output? Number one, is increasing by the day. Number two, if you have enteral content, enteral in the sense you get to see bile, you get to see the bowel content in the drain, yes, it becomes a priority to enter.
Yes,
you see blood in the drain, fresh blood in the drain, it becomes a point to again re-enter. Again, there is a way how you restore, which also helps you to do. Dr. Abhay sir was repeatedly asking you what type of anastomosis you are familiar, because that is the one which is going to govern. See, if you have done a white type of anastomosis with dunk of the distal pancreas, little bit of amylase leak or little bit of pancreatic leak, you tend to wait. But if you have done a pancreatic or gastrostomy and you have a leak, then the indication to enter is much earlier, right? The POPF, the Atlanta guidelines have come very recently. Last year it has come, it is open access. Re-entry guidelines following a high pancreatic post-operative fistula is a separate question for you, right? So you should be aware. There are some indications which can be managed with endotherapy or a guided aspiration also is possible.
Yes.
Restoration by way of a pancreatic jejunostomy and gastrojejunostomy gives you more leverage, or you can wait a little longer. If you have done a pancreatic gastrostomy, your re-entry threshold has to be much lower, right? And there are many indications apart from your increasing fluid alone. The most important thing is when you have half a liter of fluid output with amylase of 10 or 20, that is not an indication for you to go in.
Yes, sir.
Please understand, drain fluid amylase and the volume and the type of fluid drives you to re-enter. All right. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
I feel like giving you distinction, Meera. So you have to answer my three questions.
Yes,
sir. What is ripple operation?
Sir? What
is, you have to answer three questions.
Yes, sir.
What do you stand first?
Yes, sir.
What is ripple operation?
Yes, sir.
What is ripple disease? And what is ripple trial?
This is a common question they will ask.
Yes,
you are going to fail. This is my ultimate.
Even after double century, bowler gets the wicket of the batsman, he is happy.
Yeah. See, I am telling you, lot of my residents are also watching. I have been all the time telling them that Abhay Dalvi is a very nice examiner to pass. But to give gold medal, he will come out with questions which are going to be really hard. Yes. Your homework for today is go back and read what is Whipple's disease.
Yes.
What is Whipple's triad?
Yes.
And what is Whipple operation? So yes, you have reached that level of questioning. So when you study so much, much better to just quickly see what is Whipple, because my next question would have been what is Whipple's first name. So that's okay. All the best to you.
Thank you, sir.
One technical question I like to ask.
Yes, sir.
You have done a resectability operability by dissecting the following middle colic vein and superior mesenteric vein, and you have made that tunnel. Are you sure that the disease is resectable or operable 100% in periampullary tumor?
On table only will come to
me. No, on table. You have made a tunnel. You have made a tunnel behind the neck of
anterior
superior mesenteric and portal vein confluence.
Yes, sir.
Are you sure that the disease is resectable now?
What is the question?
Do you get me? One of the sign of resectability is that you pass your finger or any instrument underneath the neck of pancreas and you make sure that from the supramesenteric vessels.
Yes, sir.
Is it the guarantee that the disease is resectable?
The portal veins also we have to see.
I have dissected the portal vein bare, the whole length. Yeah. Are you sure that the disease is resectable? Yes or no? Or 100%?
Oh.
Where you can get trouble now? You have transected the pancreas.
Sorry, sir. You have transected?
The pancreas.
Yes, sir.
You have just transected the head of pancreas.
Yes, sir.
Sir has told that portal vein is free.
Yes, sir. He
is not convinced that tumor is operable. You have sort of gone to a phase of non-reversibility. That's a totally different ballgame. But having transected the head, you need to remove something more from the portal vein on the inferior aspect than infromedial aspect. What is the structure of the pancreas which you are concerned if it is involved?
Yes.
Very good. So, I think you have done well.
Meera, what is tunnel of love? Meera, tunnel of love.
So, the area of post-retropancreatic zone,
Prasad, sir.
Portal vein, superior mesenteric vein, the tunnel is called the tunnel of love. Right? You don't normally...
Thank you, Kanaka. And thank you very much.
One more question. There is a periampullary tumor.
Yes, sir.
It is very small on CT scan, on EUS. It is biopsy proven on EUS and biopsy.
Yes, sir.
It's a very small, very hardly identifiable tumor on CT scan.
Yes, sir.
What information do you want from your radiologist so that you don't end up in mess on table? There is no question of encasement or abutment of superior mesenteric vein or artery, right? Yes, what is your information you want from your radiologist other than tumor?
Lymph nodal status, sir.
When the mass is barely visible, there won't be lymph nodes. And that otherwise also your radiologist is going to report.
But yes, sir.
Question, what more do you want technically so that you don't end up in a suit? Most of the time radiologists do report, but still, say if the institute is not having proper exposure of periampullary tumor in as far as number of cases are concerned, he may miss. What I am interested in knowing CT scan from radiologist, or you will like to go yourself to console and look for certain.
I would appreciate you give the answers, sir, please.
So, what you know is from where the hepatic artery is arising. Is there any abnormal or an accessory hepatic artery or not?
Yes, sir.
You must remember that there can be common hepatic artery arising from superior mesenteric artery itself, and there may not be any other artery.
Yes, sir.
This is one. Second thing, there can be accessory right hepatic artery arising from superior mesenteric artery.
Okay, sir.
There can be left accessory hepatic artery arising from left gastric artery.
So yes, these sir.
Anomalies, you must ask your radiologist to report.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Okay, sir.
If it is the solitary hepatic artery arising from superior mesenteric artery itself,
yes,
you
sir.
May have to, you may damage it and you may have to ligate or you may have to call vascular surgeon and it can create a havoc.
Yes.
Right?
Okay. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. With that, I think we will come to the end of the session. I would now like to take the feedback from the examiners. Let Abhay sir give the final word. Before that, let me go through Dr. Jayalal, your comment and recommendation for this student, sir.
Really, she has done very well. And yes. As rightly said by Dr. Abhay Dalvi, sir, and she has very well clearly passed the examination. And very consciously, she was answering to the question. She is not getting into controversies, and that is good. And we are very slow in answering. That is also good. And I think almost you are done very well. And this topic has covered a lot of good things. And I just congratulate the candidate for the excellent presentation.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Professor J.V. Prakash from Tirupati, your comment, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Before giving my comment, I want to express my sincere thanks to Kanakavel for giving this platform to share today on the happy birthday of Dr. Abhay Dalvi, my friend, guru, and president-elect. And thank you very much, Dr. Abhay Dalvi, once more again. Happy to see you here. And Jayalal, my friend, and Sameer, Anandi Madam, everybody. Thank you very much, Kanakavel, once again. Coming to this candidate's performance, extremely well. Well composed and wins the hearts of all the examiners, and very difficult to win Dr. Abhay Dalvi. He too really is impressed that you are really got gold medal, Dr. Meera Pariyar.
Thank you, sir.
God
Thank
bless you.
You. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor G.V. Dr. Professor Thank Samir Ranjan Naik from
Rajapur. Sir, nice presentation. Dr. Meera, nice presentation.
Thank
Keep
you,
it up.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Professor Anandi Madam.
Meera, you did a good job of work. I think you have prepared very well and you made it today. Hope you do it in the exam also. Congratulations and all the best.
Thank you, ma'am.
Professor Hitesh Andaria, please.
Meera, congratulations. I was not connected with this link when you were presenting. I'd like to know from where are you?
Sir, Kerala, sir.
Which medical college?
I'm studying in Ramaya Medical College, Bangalore, sir.
Which?
MS Ramaya, sir.
MS Ramaya Medical College.
Okay. Very well done. Everybody tried to pull you, but you cleared the tunnel very well. Very well done. Congratulations. You thoroughly deserve a big applause.
Please pass on inquiries to Professor Kalevani Madam in Ramaya. I hope she is the head of the department, right?
Dr. Rudresh, sir, is the head of the department. Kalevani, ma'am.
And our kind inquiries to him. Dr. Ganesh Babu, Professor Ganesh Babu, your comments, please.
Yeah, Meera, you really did very well.
Thank you, sir.
The basic thing what you really make sure in the exam is, like what Abhay sir is repeatedly asking is that basic thing, everybody knows the theory very well. Pupils, everything, everybody knows. How you prepare the patient, how will you manage, how will you console the patient, and how will you make fit for surgery. That's the thing you should be very careful. So
yes,
that's
sir.
The thing. Anyway, good.
Sir, your comments, please.
Good afternoon. Dr. Meera, you have done well. I came two times to your college as an external examiner. So you are doing well. So happy birthday from Abhay sir. Is there?
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Every day, weekly twice, we are conducting related examination. So every you have to tell all your friends also.
Yes, sir.
Accommodate this one. Anyway, all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Professor Abhay Dalvi, your closing comment, sir.
Both the candidates were good. This basically, I think we have to give full credit to Kanakavel for conducting it, and a round of applause. Well, because it's a huge effort. I think was a little fast. If he slows down, he will be surely a good candidate. As far as Meera is concerned, very well balanced, very well composed. He has moved north from Kerala to Bangalore to study and become a surgeon. As soon as this COVID business stops, there is a flight from Bangalore to Mumbai. I will welcome her in my institute as an assistant professor for sure. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone. I would like to thank Professor Jayalal, Professor Samir Ranjan Naik, Professor G.V. Prakash, Professor Hitesh Andaria, Professor Anandi Madam, Professor Ganesh Babu, Professor Vivekananda Subramanian, and Professor Abhay Dalvi for their patience and their valued time for the students. And I also thank the students who presented the cases today and for the professors under whom they permitted to present the cases. I thank all the students for maintaining discipline and quietness. A lot of questions as you've been asking were asked by the examiners. The next class will be on Friday. We'll share the information with you. With that, with the permission of the faculty, I sign off this meeting. Thank you for sharing your time with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.